I'm back with Sermon 9 of DOC SIN. Just recapping and just focusing back in what I was talking about is that we have a choice. We all are carrying around a passport of sin. And that goes back to Adam and Eve. We're all carrying around a passport of sin. And Jesus, just like Noah built an ark. Noah was diligent and listened to God. Was diligent and obedient to God. If you're listening to your hearts tonight and you're listening to the Holy Spirit and there's something burning on your heart, you can also have this passport, this document passport. Instead of this document of sin, you can have the document of Jesus Christ, which he promises you life. He promises you eternal life through Jesus Christ. If you accept Jesus Christ in your life, then you have a new life in Jesus Christ, and your old self passes away and he forgives you. So just capping back on what we were talking about is being diligent and obedient to God and looking at God's grace and doing the will of God and listening to God. As it says here, Jesus gave them this answer, "I tell you the truth, the Son can do nothing by himself, and he cannot do what he sees his Father doing, but he sees his Father's doing, because whatever his Father does, the Son also does." Jesus gave the answer, "I tell you the truth, the Son can do nothing by himself. He can do only what he sees his Father doing, because whatever his Father does, the Son also does." John 5:19. Just capping off is that we need to look at something here. It's gonna be done. What happens if Noah said, "Well, God, it's gonna get built. It's going to happen." No, Noah didn't say it's going to happen. It will happen. And the will of God and Noah being diligent and obedient to God, and though that his neighbors would have laughed at him and mocked him and did whatever, he still listened and was diligent and obedient to God. And I just want to read this out from the book that I was showing you before. And it says here, and it's written by Lowell Alexandra, Dave Clark, Dan Notch, and Tony Wood from Experiencing God, Music for Knowing and Doing the Will of God, 1999, Star Song Records. It's gonna get done. Have we all heard that before? It's gonna get done. I feel like Moses facing the Red Sea, or the disciples looking out on the multitudes to feed. "Lord, I have followed you too far to think of turning back. It all seems so impossible unless I face the fact." It's going to get done. You're going to have to do it. Then this world will come to see your power through it. "Father, I trust, I believe it's true. It's going to get done. It's going to have to come from you. Here in the corner with the back against the wall, I'm just a prisoner of the habitat when worries come to call. I know miracles to you and all the commonplace, but you have to pardon me if I stand here amazed. What a thrill when this world sees it's nothing, something. It is not something that I have did for you, but something that you did for me. What a thrill when this world can see it is not something that I did for you, but something that you did through me." Everything is through God. Everything is through God. And as it was saying before, Jesus gave this answer, "I tell you the truth, the Son can do nothing by himself. He can do only what he sees his Father doing, because whatever his Father does, the Son also does." John 5:19. What a thrill when this world can see it's not something I did for you, but something that you did through me. You did through God. It's not about, "I'm going to do this and I'm going to do this. I will do this and I will do the will of God and I will listen to what the Holy Spirit is talking to me." In Mark 11:24, "Whatever you ask for in prayer, believe that you will receive it and you will be yours." Believe it, not you're going to believe it. You will believe it and it will be yours. "Whatever you ask for in prayer, believe it that you have received it and it will be yours." if we walk in the light as he in the light, and we have fellowshiped with one another, and the blood of Jesus, his son, purifies us from all sin. 1 John 1:7. If we walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship with one another. The blood of Jesus and his son purifies us from sin. So these are just little scriptures that come out of the thing. Love God. Jesus replied, love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and this is the first and greatest commandment. Matthew 22:37-8. Do not love the world of anything in the world. If anyone loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him. For everything in the world, the cravings of sinful man, the lust of his eyes, the boasting of what he has does, comes not from the Father, but from the world. And every member of the church must submit to the lordship of Christ, of his own life, and Christ's headship over the church. Every member of a church must submit to the lordship of Christ over his own life and Christ's headship over the church. It's not saying that every member of the church must submit to the lordship of the Christ and use the church as a fashion statement or see it as, oh well, am I being a doer of God? It's a matter of doing it. And it is a matter of being diligent and obedient to God, of his own life and Christ's headship over the church. That is getting into a little bit more complications. But I just want to sort of tie this up now and finish off what I was saying about Noah, which was the means preserve him for the trial of his faith and obedience, both providence of God and grace of God, the own crown of obedience and diligence. Noah's faithful triumph over corrupt reasoning, the rear so large, a building such as one has never saw, and provided the food of living creatures which require from the great deal of care and labours and expense. His neighbours would have laughed at him, but all these such objections Noah by faith got over. His obedience was ready and resolute. Having begun to build, he did not leave off till he had finished. So he did, and so must we do. If we decide to give Jesus, we decide to accept Jesus Christ into our lives, then it is called building. And we continue to build stronger each day in Jesus Christ. And what we need to do is continue to build like Noah built the ark. And we must continue to build until Jesus Christ comes back, which will sweep the world of unbelievers into a pit of destruction. Christ, the true Noah, which same shall comfort us, hath by his suffering already prepared the ark and kindly invited us, the faith, to enter it. While the day of his patience continues, let us hear and obey his voice. Let us hear and obey God's voice. I want to leave it there, and through the grace of God, I just want to finish up in prayer. And I just want people to realize that we need to come to God with obedience and diligence. We need to come to God with obedience and diligence, just like Abraham was tested with Isaac. We need to also know and fear God. We know not to see religion as a fashion statement. We need to also remember to swim against the stream and to appear for God when no one else will appear for him. We need to stand up as God's people, and we need to accept Jesus Christ into our heart. So I'm going to leave it there. While the day of patience continues, let us hear and obey his voice. Thank you, Jesus, for this sermon. Thank you, Lord. Lord, just teach us to be diligent and obedient to you, to hear your voice, and allow the Holy Spirit to burden our hearts every day and touch our hearts, Lord Jesus. In the blood of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.